It's 2030, and Anna's company is celebrating. Her Alzheimer's drug was just approved by the FDA, America's Food and Drug Administration. It can now be given to patients. Regulatory approval is one of three major milestones in a drug's life cycle. There's also obtaining its patent and the expiration of the patent. As Anna's drug makes it to each milestone, it undergoes three processes: research and development, commercialization, and manufacturing. During R&D, Anna's lab targeted a mechanism involved in Alzheimer's and found a molecule that slows it down, potentially delaying the progression of the disease. This discovery stage often lasts years and works off of research done by the broader scientific community. Some labs have been researching a cure for HIV for the past 30 years, for instance. But Anna found her molecule, and as soon as it showed promise, she patented her discovery. This gave her exclusive use of the molecule for 20 years, and it's when the countdown to monetize her discovery began. After the discovery stage come trials. First, preclinical trials on animals, and then clinical trials on humans. In phase one of clinical trials, Anna tested only whether the drug is safe on a handful of people. In phase two, she also tested how well the drug works, and in phase three, she tested the drug on a larger and more diverse population, seeing whether her drug has an impact that's statistically significant. These trials can take years, about 4 years on average, and they're extremely expensive to organize and run. And did you notice that we went from calling it Anna's molecule to Anna's drug? That's because throughout her research, Anna learned how the molecule works best as an active ingredient, what dosage is needed, under what conditions it works best, what inactive ingredients it should be mixed with, and this is drug development. Anna's trials were a success. Now it's time to bring it to market, or in other words, commercialize her drug. But before any drug is manufactured for commercial use or marketed, it must be first approved by regulators. Regulators from around the world go through Anna's work, checking whether their requirements were followed and deciding whether her drug is safe enough to bring it to their market. National regulators may also be involved in setting prices or discovering how much of a drug's cost the government healthcare system will reimburse. Generally, regulators take over a year to approve a drug, decide its reimbursement, and set prices. This process can be fast-tracked in extraordinary cases, such as a global pandemic, when the need for the drug is urgent. Once this regulatory work is complete, the commercial team can then launch the drug, market it, and sell it. We'll discuss these activities in more detail later. And remember the trials from the R&D stage? They're not entirely over. Once the drug is broadly available to the public, Anna's team will run phase 4 trials, investigating how the drug works on a much larger population in real-world conditions, its longer-term effects, and interactions with other drugs. Once Anna's drug is approved, it can be manufactured in commercial quantities, at scale, safely, and consistently. Pharma manufacturing processes vary significantly. It all starts with production. With small molecule drugs, active ingredients can be synthesized easily through a chemical process. But with biologics, active ingredients must be grown. The production process relies on live cells or viruses, highly sterile environments, and specialized equipment. Because of these needs and the scale of operations required by the industry, as much as 60% of drug manufacturing is outsourced to dedicated drug manufacturing companies. Anna's drug will then go through the formulation step, where the active ingredient is combined with inactive ones, the drug is put into its final form, and dosage. A pill's ingredients are put into a capsule, a biologics components are filtered and combined, and vaccines are filled into vials or syringes. Lastly, the drug is packaged for distribution. Pills go into blister packs, and vaccine vials go into refrigerated containers. From there, the drug gets distributed, much like any other product. Distributors and aggregators take packaged drugs and deliver them to pharmacies, hospitals, doctor's offices, and for OTC drugs, retailers and grocery stores. This life cycle is what makes pharma such a unique industry and drives its economics. It's reflected in the cash flow of Anna's drug, which looks like this. First, there's major upfront investment going into R&D. In fact, the pharma industry spends more on R&D than any other industry. It's about 20% of sales, compared to about 6% in aeronautics, for example. Then, once the drug is approved and exclusive sales begin, revenues rise as Anna's drug becomes available around the world. But when the patent runs out, biosimilars emerge, competing with her branded drug at a lower cost, and revenues fall. Now let's discuss in more detail how a drug gets commercialized.